I think for now, no. Not in camera.
How do we get this looks so favor should keep following us?
It's God. Don't play me.
Your body build? Is it God? The spots?
That's all me.
Just you.
Everything is God. Come on.
Stop being modest. Just be real for a minute.
I don't know. What am I? I'm just being me. I'm being a friend.
Friend?
You know me. This is I am. If I fake it, it's not going to go well with us.
Really?
Yeah.
So besides acting, what do you do?
Wow, this is a question people always ask me. Friends, family. I think I'm living a pretty much boring life. Like, to me it's all about movies. Like, if I'm not acting, I'm watching it. I watch soccer sometimes, and I play it, but I can't remember the last time I played soccer. I think I live a pretty much boring life.
Means it has taken all of your time.
It has, but I do hang out.
Let's take it this way. What if you weren't acting? What would you be doing?
Wow. Let me see.
Be entertaining in what?
I've not had a plan B for like forever.
You're not for real.
I'm serious. Like,
when did you get one?
Film has been the thing for me for like since day one. I'm not having a plan B. I can't say if film don't work for me, what am I going to do?
So it was like a childhood dream.
Do all that.
You grew up with it?
Yeah, it's been planned. I've been planning to get on the camera, do things, do stuff. You know, just going to school, studying to please my parents. You know?
And finally it came knocking. Talking of parents, how did they receive it?
Well, I went to school. Well, before I did my first film, I was living abroad.
Okay.
I was hustling abroad, you know. So I was really independent, you know. I was really taking care of my parents and stuff. So if I decide that it's film now,
so they didn't see like
I was really mad. I've never been a mommy's boy. Never.
That is wrong.
Nope. I used to be a pain in the neck.
So who do you confide in then?
Oh. I think I talk to my mom.
Hmm.
It doesn't mean I'm not a pain in the neck. I was a troublesome kid. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. But I love my parents. I really love my parents.
Yeah. That made you what you are. So tell me, how was growing up like? Was it all glory?
It was. No, I was. I lived an average life. I'm not from that kind of home.
Okay.
But my parents did well for me. I think in Cameroon we have. I think do we have three classes in Cameroon?
We do.
We're just average.
We do.
We do
at our own level as we rate it. Yes, we do.
I was fine growing up. I had a pretty much good life, you know, experience in school. I was a superstar in school all my life, so.
So he has been a superstar
all my life? I was that guy in school.
Yeah.
I've been okay.
So to an extent, you were destined to be the superstar.
Am I a superstar?
I can't say.
I'm not there yet. I'm still working extremely hard to get there, and I will.
On that note, I think I need to touch up my face because this guy is just too cute for me to sit by him looking untouched.
Thank you.
Well, still with me is Franz Zaya, and there's a lot I want to discover about him. And I know you're for sure thinking, what is this thing about this guy? What makes him who he is? Here is that place for you to know. So if you're just joining us, take your seat. You're on the talk show Inside Out. Right.
Yes, my dear.
So tell me, which was that moment where you were like, wow, this is it, I'm not going back?
Well, it was when, after I did my first film, back in 2012, like I said,
yeah.
It was not that difficult thing. I had some people, like I was saying,
okay.
My first film back in 2012, they had no...
Which film was that?
I think Different Kinds of Men.
Yay! I watched it!
Really? They had no director.
Honestly, I didn't know it was from. Isn't that
that's
funny?
That's what I was just about to explain to you. Yeah, they had no direct, no reflection, like, no impact. You know, people don't even know that was me. If I don't say, you know, the guy, Frank Zaya, they won't know.
Not that people didn't know it was you, but people only be relating back to it like,
Now you know me. If I insert Different Kinds of Men here right now, you wouldn't become nice. Let's trust me.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm serious.
I'll verify.
But when I produced my first film, Chasing Tales, that was when I realized that, okay, I have something in me because of the critics, you know, what people were saying.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they took it like a big deal. So I felt like, wow, if I can influence people like this, if people could believe in me like this, it means I can really build this thing.
Just like that.
Yeah.
And that was...
I'm still around the corner.
And the calls kept coming.
Yeah, it's been good. It's been nice.
Any international collaborations?
Well, for the first time, yes. Presently, we're doing a series here in Lübe.
Okay.
I don't know if I should talk about this series, but I can only say I'm working with Nadia Bari and Ime Bishop. Yeah.
Seriously?
Yeah, it's a good one.
Might be privileged to see them.
The world, you'll see. I really want to talk about it, but I don't know if I should. So.
Okay, we are keeping that on the wraps.
I haven't talked
you
to
you. You don't want to let the cat out of the bag, so soon.
Exactly.
Can we get a peek into the name?
Of the movie?
Series?
That's like giving the cat away. But I know I'm playing Nadia Bari's boyfriend.
Yeah.
And I'm playing Emil Bishop's body, so it's a beautiful experience.
Wow.
Working with these professionals, you feel like, wow, I've been playing all along.
That brings me to my next question. I was kind of thinking, has this guy kissed on set so far? And then he just spits it to my face. I'm acting boyfriend to Nadia Boy.
Yeah, like after I kissed on that first movie, they keep giving me more than I kiss. So I don't know if it's a good thing or not. Because actually,
you tell me why should they keep giving you kissing moves?
I don't know. There's something people don't get. Kissing is like getting physical like that is the most difficult part of acting. Imagine kissing someone.
I hear you guys say you fake it.
Well, acting is being someone else. Like, you take yourself out of you and represent something else.
They actually do it.
You have to do it. When you kiss, you have to make it look real. Sometimes, you put your emotions in it.
Okay, let's take it this way, right? What if you were crushing on that person?
Good for you. Or good for me. I'll make the kiss look more real.
Really? And then after that?
Life continues.
Life continues. Just like that, you got the kiss.
That's it. You're not serious. If you like the person, you can go ahead and do whatever you're doing after the camera stops.
Well, talking of crushes, anybody in the entertainment industry so far?
No.
Just didn't come.
No. There's so many amazing girls in the camera.
There should be one at least.
Actually, I'm not crushing on anybody right now. I'm not.
Not just
film.
Not just movies, music, everything entertaining. I'm not getting funny. I've had even one. Seriously.
Wow. I like a lot of Cameron actors, and I like them.
Anis, give me a
crushing. Crushing is different. Crushing is like you want something more if you're given the opportunity.
Sure.
So, I don't see none. Right now, I don't see none.
Okay, let's take Africa.
Africa. Yeah, I still making it worse. Right? I don't see it. But if you call names, I might tell you that maybe not.
Okay, let's do it this way. What if you left your phone here, probably on charge,
okay,
and then you come and get a missed call, probably from Sandoval, and then a message from him at Cindy,
okay,
and then a call me back,
okay,
from, say, Rukwete, who okay. Will you call back?
I can only call one of them.
Yeah, just one.
I'll call Sandoval.
Why?
I'll call Sandoval.
Why?
Right now, I think I like her better. I like her right now more professionally. I'll call her, but she might give me business.
So you might give me business.
You're surprised, right?
Not that I'm surprised.
You expected another name.
No, not like I was expecting another name. I'm just happy at least you picked a name. Yeah. So why wouldn't you call Emare or Ruth?
Let me see. Ruth has never put money in my bank account.
Yeah.
Emadi has never put money in my bank account. Sandoval has, like twice or three times. So I'll call her. Besides, she's sexy.
Somebody says, keep your new friends closer and the old.
They are all my friends.
No, I'm just trying to say, if she has already put money in your bank
account. She'll keep putting money in my bank account.
She might get failed. And another person would want
to
start.
Do you know why she's putting money in my bank account? Let me get this out. Do you know why she's putting money in my bank account?
She's giving you business, probably calling you for a job.
Yeah.
And I would say I will buy that idea because I've seen you with her on America Visa.
Yeah, but we just did a commercial. I'm dying to come. I don't know what was mine. We did a wine commercial. Mm. When you're doing commercials, that's where the money is. You know what I'm saying?
There's a lot of exciting after the break. We'll get to know him better. Thanks for staying tuned with me. And if you're just joining us, then you're on the talk show Inside Out. And with me is Frank Sayer, one of Cameroon's finest. Frank, thank you for being here.
I told you before, it's always a pleasure.
So tell me, how do you manage the challenges of being a public figure?
Well, you just have to separate your life from from the actor with your private stuff. You don't have to put them together. Besides, there's one thing about me, this is how different I am. I don't see myself as a celebrity. I'm living a normal life.
A normal life. Okay, I'll take you back to American Visa.
Okay.
Where Sandoval came to you as a mom. A grandmom with all desperation to travel abroad. Just imagine yourself on the streets and this grandmom, or just a normal age woman comes and spits at you, you this giant you get. How would you take that? Considering she has seen that, how would you react to that?
I'll run away. She's hitting me with a stick. That's the only thing. I can't hit her back.
Okay.
So I'll run away.
I thought you would have taken our time to explain to her that. That wasn't Frank.
Oh, okay, I get the context now. Yeah, I should do that. But I'll run away first. It's a mistake.
You give her space.
I'll give her space and I explain to her that was acting if she doesn't understand. Because apparently she doesn't understand. That's why she's getting a mistake.
Okay, we'll take another scenario. Considering you have a white party and you're stepping out. Probably maybe entering a car or your car or whatever, and then a small fan of yours, a young fan, just runs to you all dirty.
That white one is different.
You're in white.
Yeah.
I'm so precise about that color, white.
friend comes to hug you.
Hug you.
No,
maybe they only see you on TV, and then fortunate for them and unfortunate for you, your wife, then fortunate for them to finally see you live.
That friend should understand. I'm not my wife and I'm not a party.
It's a baby friend.
Baby.
It's a small child. And you might not even see him or her coming.
Well, if it happens that I don't see him or her coming, I'll just, alright, it's okay, it's a baby. But if I see the baby coming, I'm going to keep it real with you. You know, it's not like I have like so many of those outfits hanging somewhere, you know?
Yeah.
You know, I'm going somewhere. I'll move on real fast, like real quick.
And what if you get all messed
that,
up?
That fat is going to see me another day.
What if you're messed up?
Yeah, that's it. That's life.
Your reactions?
That's a baby. There's nothing you can do about that.
Bro, no. Honestly?
Honestly, what can you do? You'll be pissed, but not at the baby. What do you expect? You come and saw me.
Really?
Okay.
No, I didn't say an adult. A baby.
We're going to have a conversation. We're going to talk.
Really?
Yeah. So you see, it's different. If an adult comes close and he makes my outfit out, it's going to be a different conversation. Baby, baby's a baby. Besides, it's adorable. One time I was in Boyo at the Nico, just in front of our studio, and we were just having a drink. We tell my editor. One kid was selling snails.
Yeah.
And she came, like, snails, cobweed and stuff. I was like, leave this shit. She was like, hey, it's you, Nesta. Because I was playing Nesta
yeah.
on Rumble. She was like, hey, you, Nesta. I'm like, wow, I felt so good.
You felt good?
Yeah. Okay. That was early on.
No, okay.
That was early on.
You didn't feel guilty.
Chasing
him away.
No, I felt kind of nice. No, I didn't chase him away. Like, you know when you're not interested in buying something and like, you just have to tell him to go, come on, I'm gonna talk here.
And then
I'm like, hey Nesta. And that was like early on in my career. I was like, wow, this is
somebody
really cool.
Recognized.
Like, just like, I'm gonna get snails right here, man.
You know, our intention here is just to know you better, know you on the inside. So any relationship?
Any relationships?
Are you thinking?
I'm not thinking. Well, I'm thinking whether I should say the way I want to say it or not.
You have to say it. It's a yes or no.
It's complicated.
No twist. Yes or no.
It's complicated.
I didn't want complicated.
It's really complicated.
Just yes or no.
Trust me, it's really complicated. I might say no and I don't get home tonight, and I might say yes and I still don't get home tonight. Let me just leave in the middle.
A public figure.
It's complicated like Facebook.
Is it a public figure?
Wow, you're good.
Is she a public figure?
It's just complicated. Public figure.
This is not fair. You're not doing this to me. It's for your fans. They want to know.
No, there's no one. There's no one.
Are you searching?
No, there's
no one. Can they send in the application?
Searching? No, I'm not searching.
But you receive applications?
I don't mind receiving some.
You still tell me, has a girl ever walked up to you and said, like, Frank, tell me I like you.
This is the truth, man. Girls have been walking up to me like since I was like
small.
But now they don't walk. No, they don't do that. Like, when I became an actor, like they just decided to stop.
What's
like, when I was in school, girls used to come to me and talk. I said stop. They just write letters, but now they don't. I don't know what's going on.
Why is that?
I have no idea. This is the truth. I'm telling you right now.
Okay, on that note, you're making it definitely not by relying on the government. So what advice would you give your fans out there who aspire to be like you?
Well, in this country, if you can rely on the government, please do. If you have an opportunity to give government money.
You and I know that opportunity won't come by just like that.
If you can't, I just want you to know one thing. If you're talking to the camera or something,
You're telling your friends.
I just want you guys to know one thing. Everything is possible. Everything is possible. There's no such thing as a pipe dream. Don't let anybody tell you that you can't do this thing because this thing is not done here because of your present circumstances. You can do it. If you want to pilot a plane, believe in yourself, you can do it. If you want to be the next Denzel Washington, just believe in yourself, you can do it. Everything you want to do is possible.
And if you want to be like Frank, just
do it.
You know, man.
I know where this is going. I know, man.
Really?
But don't tell me to put numbers on those things. Come on, don't do this.
You know, man. How many months do we have?
In a year?
In a year.
It's 12. It's 12?
12. Okay. Some months have 31 days.
Yeah.
Some have 30 days.
Yeah.
How many months have 28 days?
28. It's only February.
Oh, 13. He got it wrong.
Repeat that question again. How many months? Just one.
How many months have 28 days?
One.
Are you sure?
How many?
Are you sure?
I am.
Really sure?
Absolutely sure.
Yay! Frank is not all around smart. He got one thing wrong.
I feel so embarrassed right now. Maybe I should go back to school or something.
Yeah. Should you?
Yeah, maybe. I feel real bad about my parents' school fees.
I really got you on that one, right?
Yeah.
12 months have 28 days. All 12 months.
I know.
Did you get it now?
I do. That's why I said I'm impressed. Like, it's tricky. I mean, I can't count.
High five.
It's tricky. It doesn't mean I can't count.
Really? Yeah. On that note, let Frank take a breather from that shop. So. Something else for Frank, was it?
It was.
I really got you there, right?
I don't feel bad per se because I know the televiewers are also like, wow, she got me too. So, we're all in the same box right now.
Anyway, I was in that box too. Somebody took me out.
Right,
and I'm glad to take you and some of your fans out too.
Thank you. I'm out.
But at least I'm just happy there was something
you did. I'm happy you got me. I'm not human.
So, who do you aspire to act with in the industry?
In Cameroon.
Africa.
In Africa.
You've broken the walls of Cameroon already.
Wow. I want to act with R&D.
Papa doesn't get
there's something about this guy. I want to act with him.
Yeah.
I want to act with Genevieve too. Genevieve and R&D.
But she's kind of pulling back.
Genevieve?
Yeah.
But she's doing bigger movies now.
So work harder. Push even harder so you get there before she retires.
Maybe by the time, retire at what age? Maybe by the time.
I mean her, not
Genevieve.
You. Yeah.
No, at what age?
Retiring from the industry, not about her age.
It's passion.
It's been decades.
People go and come back.
It's been decades.
Well, if when the time comes, she's not around the world, I'm like, okay.
I really need someone I really want to. Yeah, he's gonna come back.
Mm-hmm. I really there's something about him that I admire. He's like that desert Washington in Africa to me. Yeah. I like the way he plays his cool.
That's a man. Come down to the youth.
To you? In Africa. So in Africa, I'm looking at just Nigeria. I don't know why.
Okay.
I'm not looking at Cameroon because
I said you already broke the walls of Cameroon. Go to South Africa, go to Kenya, go to Ghana. Just move around.
I really don't have anybody in Africa like that I know of. I'm really that's the best part of it. I'm really young.
Really?
I don't know what I can say. So all the young guys, I think if I want to, I can bring them here to work.
Okay, on that note, I'll ask, who is is your greatest competitor? Like for me, I would say it's myself. I always like to tell myself that you can do better. You can be better than what you are. If I look at some other person, I'll try to copy that person. So I tell myself, I am my competitor. I always try to get better. So is that the case with you? Do you aspire to be like somebody or you just want to keep?
There are people I look up to that I know I want to be like them. I want to talk about competition, like I want to be better than someone else. Nah, that's not me. I work, like I told you before, I work really hard.
Okay.
I'm trying to get better, and I'm getting better. That's what I care about, get better. You know, I just have to look at myself, you know? You can never be someone else. And by me beating you doesn't make me any better. Yeah. I might beat you by two, and someone else is going higher. But I might control myself, and I improve by 10.
I hate you, Cameron.
Yeah. I'm angry.
Sure.
True, Cameron. 100%. What do you think? I'm
just trying to see if truly you're Cameron. Can you please tell the grandmas out there in your mother tongue, like, hello?
That's like a little difficult.
You said you're a true Cameroonian.
Oh, that's what the truth is. I thought the truth is my parents are Cameroonian.
You started this twist. So let's do
the
twist.
The truth is my mom and my dad, like biology, when we come together, help me, Cameroonian.
I know you're all Cameroonian. Are you really?
Wait, how do you say good morning like in my dialect?
He's asking me. Are you for real?
Wow.
And if you get it wrong, you know those grandmas now? They just begin to. You know, fire loose.
I was about to say good morning, and I forgot. That is like almost.
Don't say good morning. Just say hi. Just say a word. Just say anything.
You won't believe it. Like I don't. Like I don't know. Someone is ready to help me right now. Is everybody could just speak louder?
Okay, on that note, we'll give him a minute to steal from somebody. The camera is on you.
Yeah, I can say good morning to my dad like any day, any time.
Good afternoon.
I can still say, but let's have a good morning. Why are you here?
Let him stand in one, so say good morning to the grandmas.
Onyima. I'm good with that. Can't you hear them saying something back to me?
Really? So according to you, you just came back. Anyway, that's a challenge for Frank. From today on, he'll learn his mother tongue.
I will learn.
Is that a promise?
I promise.
Please, Grandma, where you meet from? Don't speak to him in English. Don't use French.
My grandma is on WhatsApp. What do you expect?
Oh goodness. These are Android mothers. And you're not doing your children any good. Well, Fran, it's been awesome having you here.
Same here, my dear.
And we hope to have you back sometime.
Any day, any time.
Will you respond to her call? Despite your tight skin.
I will respond. It's fun.
It's not just about answering.
I've been smiling all through.
Have you?
Yeah.
I didn't notice.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Can you smile for us? Can you smile for us now? Are you faking now or are you sorry?
I'm faking this one.
Now you're laughing.
Yeah.
Well, on that note, we call it quit on your talk show Inside Out. I have been your presenter, Solange Tanjung. The makeup was done by Enoch Corey. Behind the cameras has been Medicom Center and every other person that assisted to make this show a success. We say kudos to you for your making Cameroon proud. Until next time, goodbye.